biomass, energy of biomass.
So what are the biomass? Do you know that one?
The energy contained inside the animals and plant materials. The energy contained in animals and plant materials we called as biomass, the energy of biomass. For examples are firewood. Firewood, you know there are various types of firewood. We use these firewood for cooking. Mainly we use this for cooking. That means we can take heat by using firewood. Coconut shells, hay, and then cow dung. Mostly in India they use dried cow dung as fuel. The heat of dried cow dung to cooking purpose. And also they use this dried cow dung for producing biogas. Like LP gas, they produce biogas using this dried cow dung. So we can use these things. We can get these ideas. Those are very valuable. So fuels produced using plant materials are considered as renewable energy sources. The fuels produced using plant and animal materials, they are called renewable energy sources. So we should plant new trees to replace those cut down. Then we can continuously take this type of biomass. So we have to plant new trees to replace those cut down. So until now we were discussing about renewable energy sources. We have discussed about solar power, wind power, and the power of flowing water and geothermal energy, and about biomass. And then we have discussed about non-renewable energy sources. Now we are going to discuss the non-renewable energy sources. What are the non-renewable energy sources? Those are the energy sources that cannot be reproduced, or otherwise it will take very long time to reproduce. So these are the non-renewable energy sources. First one is mineral oil. Mineral oil is a fossil fuel. Do you know what is fossil fuel? Plant and animal matter subjected to different reactions in underground. So fossil fuels are plant and animal matter. Those are subjected to different reactions in underground. So underground there are fossils. So the fuel can be extracted from this fossil called as fossil fuel. So mineral oil is one of fossil fuel. So mineral oil is trapped among the rocks in the earth crust. Mineral oil is trapped among the rocks in the earth crust. So metal tubes are drilled inside these rocks and oils should be taken. We have to drill the metal tubes inside these rocks to take the mineral oils. Crude oil is extracted as mineral oil in the earth crust. Crude oil is taken. Then from these crude oil, other oils are extracted. So petrol, diesel and kerosene oils are extracted from these crude oil. You can see the pictures in page number 123. Crude oil, diesel, kerosene and petrol. So what are the advantages of mineral oil? So you know these mineral oils are easy to use. Handling is easy. And also those can be converted into energy by modern machines very easily. So mostly we are using these mineral oil. Another non-renewable energy source is coal. What is coal? Coal means galangal. So coal is a fossil fuel. It is also a fossil fuel similar to mineral oil. So there are coal mines. Coal mines mean gal anguru akhara kiyala kiyenawa. The coal mines are found among the inner rock layers of our earth. We can found these coal mines inner rock of our earth crust. So what are the advantages of using this coal? It is easy to excavate. Excavating is easy and we can generate a lot of heat. We can generate more heat and handling is easy. So there are more coal mines than mineral oil mines in our earth. So these are the advantages of using coal. But there is a disadvantage also. That is, the gases emitting after combustion cause environmental pollution. So after the combustion they emit gases. So these gases cause environmental pollution. That is the disadvantage. Let's go to another non-renewable energy source. Natural gases. So what are natural gases? The methane gas trapped within the rocks of the earth crust we called as natural gases, the methane gas. So natural gases are also a type of fossil fuels. So here also metal tubes are drilled into rocks and these gases are taken out. Metal tubes are drilled into rocks and we can take the methane gas. So these gases are used to mostly cooking purpose. And also in cold countries they use these methane gas to heat their house as heaters. They use these natural gases. There are some advantages using natural gases. The natural gases are cheap and they are easy to use. And also the pollution, environmental pollution is also less. But there is a disadvantage, that means the supply is limited. So there is limited amount of natural gases within the rocks. So there are some advantages and also disadvantages of using natural gases.
Nuclear power. Have you heard about nuclear power? Nashtika Balaya. The energy generated by nuclear reactions. Nuclear reactions mean Nashtika Pratikriya. Because of nuclear reactions, the nuclear power is generated. Do you know the sun? Energy is generated in the sun because of the nuclear reactions. So during these reactions, one type of atoms convert into another type of atom. This is happening in these reactions. So uranium is a radioactive atom. Vikiranashili mooladravya, vikiranashili paramanu tamai uranium. And also there is another one, thorium. Uranium, thorium are radioactive atoms. So these types of radioactive atoms are used in mostly to generate nuclear power. So this uranium is used in nuclear power plant electricity, Nashtika Viduli Balagara. So they generate electricity by using nuclear power. There are advantages and also so many disadvantages in using this nuclear power. Advantage is very little amount of radioactive atoms are sufficient to generate vast amount of energy. Very little amount. We need very little amount of radioactive atoms. But it generates vast amount of energy. That is the advantage of using nuclear power. But there are so many disadvantages. High expenditure. That means it will take high expenditure for installing and also maintain the nuclear power plants. And highly toxic materials are released as byproducts. Release highly toxic materials as byproducts. So these byproducts should be stored for thousands of years without exposing to the environment. So that is again highly expensive task. So, and also it will cause hazardous conditions if radioactive substances are leaked by accidentally. It will be harmful to man and also our environment. If accidentally these radioactive substances exposed to our environment, it will affect people and the environment, which will lead to a tragic end. Okay, I think you have heard about explosion at Fukushima nuclear plant in Japan. You can find information about explosion of Fukushima nuclear plant in Japan. Find information about it. So, those are about non-renewable energy sources. So, until now we have discussed renewable energy sources and also non-renewable energy sources. Okay? Sustainable usage of energy sources. Do you know non-renewable resources will disappear one day? So, it is our duty, it is our responsibility to protect these non-renewable resources. And also we have to use these both type of energy sources in a sustainable way. What you can do for that one? We can minimize using domestic electricity. At home you can do it, you can practice to minimize the usage of domestic electricity. And we can walk or use a bicycle for traveling short distance. You can enjoy by walking or traveling a bicycle. And we can use common transportation methods instead of using personal vehicles, and use hybrid or electric vehicles, and use optional energy sources whenever possible. In our home, we can use solar energy and avoid busy hours for traveling. That means avoid the traffic time and minimize using plastic. Likewise, we can do so many things to protect non-renewable and renewable energy sources. Okay, now we cover the lesson. Let's go to the summary. Here in this lesson, we have discussed about energy sources. Energy sources are divided into two groups, renewable and non-renewable. And renewable energy sources must be used as much as possible. Then non-renewable energy sources can be, should be protected. So we have discussed what are the renewable and non-renewable energy sources, what are the examples, and there are advantages and also disadvantages of both renewable and non-renewable energy sources. So last, sustainable usage of energy sources will help for the future generation to use them. Okay, now we cover the lesson. You can do the exercise. Okay, I think you are happy now. We finish all the lessons in grade 7 science. You can read the two books again. Okay, you can read the books and you can do the unit test, and you can do the exercises and more papers. Then you can get more knowledge. And thank you all of you that watched my videos until the last one. I think you all have taken knowledge and some value from these videos. And also, I take this opportunity to thank my husband, Mr. Lahiru Madhushankar Kumar Siri, who edited all the videos. It was a very difficult task, but he has done it perfectly. Thank you very much. Okay, we can finish now. Be happy always and take care. Bye-bye.